Hello, there again. Welcome to today's session with GA Scientific. Today we'll be exploring one fundamental principle of light, which is the fact that it travels in a straight line. This is popularly known as the rectilinear propagation of light. So yeah, what is this rectilinear propagation of light, and what is so fascinating about this? One thing you have to realize is that underlying most of the successful practical explorations of light properties, so reflection, refraction, diffraction, all of these, is the fact that light is able to travel in a straight line. So let me give you an example. So take a very plain surface, right? So you have a ray of light that is incident on this surface. So just as you're very familiar with, we have to draw our normal to the surface, and this angle right here becomes the angle of incidence, right? If light were not to be traveling in a straight line, there is absolutely no way you can predict that the light is going to bounce off of this surface at this angle right here, which is called the angle of reflection. And we know that these two angles, they add up to 90 degrees, so they are complementary. And the reason why we know this is because light travels in a straight line. So yeah, basically the fact or the principle that light travels in a straight line underlies so many things, and that is what we are basically going to explore today. We first begin with two different categories of these components. So the first part is going to be our light contraption, and then the other one is going to be our pinhole contraption. And then we move on to talk about why we have this circuit over here. I'm probably sure you know why, but we will actually talk about that. So to do a very quick like run through of what we have. So the first part, as I said, is called the light contraption. And the light contraption composes this piece we have right here, which is our LED stand. So you're going to put the LED light, the bulb, into one of these holes. And as you see in a couple of minutes, this will be this together with this structure over here. Plus, of course, our LED bulb is going to serve as our light source. And so that's our light contraption for this exploration. Also, we have these dark slabs. You have a single slit, multiple slits, and then one of these as well. And this is basically what we call the pinhole contraption. So together with these are basically used to stabilize the contraptions. So as you realize in a couple of minutes, you realize how they are actually being used. But these dark slabs will be used to direct the rays of light so that we will be able to effectively explore the principle that we'll be exploring today. So yeah, so moving on to this particular circuit, I'm pretty sure you know why we have this circuit over here. And that is basically the circuit that is going to power our LED lights that we have. Okay, so this is basically the actual circuit, the circuit diagram that I just showed you. This is the actual circuit, as you can see. So we have the battery, and then we have the makeshift switch, and then we have the LED bulb. So the battery just powers our LED bulb, which serves as the primary source of light for demonstrating this principle. So this is just a quick run through of how to basically put together your light contraption. So as you can see right here with our LED stand, what you do is you gently push this structure over here. I call it the stability structure. You can name it however you want. But essentially, yeah, you just push it very gently into the projection. This is the projection. So push it in very gently into the projection, as you can see. And then you push the other ends into it as well. So try to do it gently and make sure that everything fits. Yeah. So we have this. And then we do a similar thing for our pinhole contraption as well. So you also push that in very gently. And then you do that for the other end as well. So yeah, just make sure that you're doing it right. So yeah, we have multiple of these, which are already put together. So yeah, these are basically, this is what composes the pinhole contraption, and that's what we'll be using. So to just dive in straight into the actual thing we'll be doing, you basically grab your LED light and then you push it into one of the holes that we have here. right? So you do this very gently, and basically this whole thing is what composes our live contractions. Okay, so then what we do next is basically to arrange our pinhole contractions in front of this, of the light contraption, right? So basically, as you know, if this is properly arranged, if it's arranged in a straight line, the light should be able to go through all of these holes, and then we should be able to observe the light at this end, right? But if one of them is shifted slightly, what you should observe is that you are no longer able to do what? To see the light that goes through like each of the pinholes, and then it's later incident on the black surface we'll be using. So yeah, I introduced the circuit to you. We showed you how the circuit was built, how you would mount your LED bulb into onto the LED stand and everything. So basically you should be okay with how things have developed so far. So what we're going to basically do is we are going to turn on the switch as I'm doing right now, and you can see immediately the LED bulb lights up, and we have these structures in front of it. And to actually examine this principle, you need to use this black surface, as I already said. If it's not very visible, you can turn over to the white surface. And yeah, it's actually much better on the white surface, so you could actually do this instead. So yeah, as you can see, the light is traveling through these pinholes onto this surface over here. To actually explore the opposite effect, so just ask yourself, what happens when you move one of these slabs slightly to the left? And because of the principle that light should travel in a straight line, when we move one of these, I'm going to move the middle one. When I move the middle one, what happens is that you no longer see this light over here. So this small green light that you're able to observe, you no longer see it. So just watch carefully as I move this slab to the side. So as you can see, there is actually no light that is visible, right? And that is the clue that, you know, light is not able to curve its way into this hole and then curve back into that hole. It travels in a straight line. Okay, yeah, so just as you saw us demonstrate, that was basically light traveling in a straight line. So you realize that as we move one of the dark slabs out of the path of the light was no longer visible on the white surface. And so that is basically the rectilinear propagation of light. So yeah, it's very simple. I'm sure you probably heard it a lot more times than I can actually imagine. But anyways, what you can do is you can explore other fascinating things like, you know, the different properties of light. So just as I sort of illustrated on the board, you know, you can use this, which is a single slit that we have right here, or you can also use the multiple slits to, you know, do very fun stuff with light, to explore the various properties of light. So with diffraction, refraction, of course, if you want to try something with reflection, definitely do go ahead and try to be a bit more mathematical with it, you know, so try to actually calculate the angle of incidence and the angle of reflection so that, you know, it further confirms that light indeed travels in what, in a straight line. Yeah, starting from our next videos, we'll actually be diving into really amazing stuff. So stay tuned for that. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and definitely do comment, because we do need those comments to be able to improve on these videos.